Brothers, welcome to another episode of TJO Men's Ministries. Hey, today's episode is a continuation of the series that we're calling Conversations with Pastor Chris. Hey, this conversation came about as I was having a conversation with Pastor Chris, and I brought up the fact that preaching seems to have changed over the last several decades. I grew up in a church with fantastic preaching. In fact, I grew up under the pastorship of what I believe to be one of the greatest preachers I've ever known. In our church, theology was priority number one. My pastor clearly understood how important it was for all believers to know the nature of God the Father, to know the nature of Jesus Christ. And his preaching was evidence of that. I hope you enjoy this conversation. Make sure to click that like button. Make sure to subscribe if you're not already subscribed. Hey, thanks for watching another episode of TJO Men's Ministries. Kim and I are of the impression that there is a serious lack in good preaching these days. You have been at the same church since you've returned from Africa.
Mm-hmm.
So you don't visit a ton of churches.
No, not in the last few years.
Kim and I have visited a number of churches. I'm gonna say easily a dozen churches over the last dozen years. While we were primarily, involved with one particular church, we had probably visited every bit of a dozen churches, and we've come to the conclusion that there is a serious lack of solid fundamental preaching in a lot of the evangelical churches today.
Any idea why?
It's not sugar in the ears.
No.
It's not what everybody wants to hear.
So we came back from Africa in 2017, end of 2017. And I've had a couple of occasions to visit some churches for a service. Prior to that, in my youth, I've been to a lot of different churches.
And, sure.
Of course, that was back then, and it was probably true back then too, I think.
Yeah. Probably less so, though.
Yes, I think so.
I know 20 years ago for myself, actually dating us a little bit, but I guess 30 years ago, when we were young men, I was a college student, and I attended college 40 miles away from here, so...
Tyndale, right?
Yeah, yeah. I went to Tyndale. So some Sunday mornings I tried to find a church in that particular area, and then some Sunday mornings I came home to my home church here in Taylor. So as a young man, I visited a lot of churches, and I feel like it wasn't as drastic. There were several churches back then that I found good preaching. What I would consider good preaching.
Okay.
Now, one of those particular churches, the pastor has moved on to a very, very different church than what he was in then. And his style of preaching reflects the type of church that he's now in. I thought he was a pretty fair preacher back in the early 90s.
So his preaching has actually changed.
Yes, over his time.
Interesting.
The size of his church has quadrupled and then some.
Yeah, that may have a lot to do with it. I think since the 90s, when you and I were in our youth, when we were young men, we're like almost exactly the same age, I think.
Yeah, I think you're a year older.
Yeah, thanks for that. So, the phenomenon of the mega church has really, you know, in 1990 there were probably fewer than 300 mega churches, I think, I've read in the U.S. There are now about 1,800, and it seems to be, quite frankly, it's almost seen as, if you're a pastor, speaking as a pastor.
Sure.
If you're a pastor, that's almost like there's a heavy influence out there to see that as the measure of success. I've succeeded as a pastor if I've got a mega church, which is usually defined as 2,000 people or more.
Okay.
And they've kind of discovered that it's hard to attract large numbers of people with the kind of preaching that you and I are talking about.
Okay.
That is really robust theologically.
Sure.
And presents a deep vision of who God is, that the number of people that will really respond to that tends to be on the smaller side.
Sure.
It's you'll attract a lot more people more quickly if you pattern your communication after the way the world communicates.
Mm-hmm.
And the things that they, and like, it's like you said, itching ears.
Mm-hmm.
What people want to hear.
Yeah.
And so that's actually, you know, it's very typical to actually, they have whole Christian marketing firms that will tell you, that have done polls of the people in the area of your church, this is what they want out of a church, because
mm-hmm.
they've sent out questionnaires, and will advise you, pattern your church after what they want. And, you know, if you build it, they will come,
right.
Kind of thing.
Right.
And it's, so many pastors are so driven by the allure of numbers, sheer numbers. Like the numbers in and of themselves validate my ministry and therefore validate me as a person, as a Christian. It's very tempting. The allure is there. But yeah, I think in the long run it's not conducive to the building up of the people and worship over time.
Brothers, I hope you enjoyed this short conversation with Pastor Chris. Hey, if you enjoy this channel, I hope that you're subscribed. I hope that you'll share our messages on your social media platforms. Share these messages with your friends. Brothers, if you would be so inclined as to support our ministry, we would love for you to go to our Patreon account. You can find that link by going to our website, teamjesusoutdoors.com, www.teamjesusoutdoors.com. In the upper right-hand corner, there's a drop-down box. Click on that box, and there's a link there that'll drive you right to our Patreon account. But hey, guys, I hope you've enjoyed this short episode. Leave us a comment in the comment box below. Let me know, do you enjoy these conversations with Pastor Chris? Is this something that you'd like to see more of? What would you like to see more of at TJO Men's Ministries? Brothers, I pray that you're growing closer to the Lord Jesus Christ. I pray that you've got your family in a good church under the leadership of a great pastor. Brothers, God bless. Tight lines. We'll see you guys on the water. Mm-hmm.